In this section, we're going to take a look at a couple of different miscellaneous topics that don't really belong in their own section per se. So these are all going to be very small little topics, just things you need to be aware of, but not stuff that's so important that we need to have many different videos on each one. In this video in particular, we're going to take a look at a new keyword called distinct. Distinct is always going to be placed inside of a select clause, and we're going to place it right after that select keyword. So you're going to see the words select distinct. Distinct is going to give you a list of all the different unique values inside of a column. So for example, if we wanted to find all the unique departments inside of our products table, we could write select distinct department from products. That would give us a list of just the distinct or unique departments inside this table. So if I take this example right here, we would take a look at the first value, toys, and we would remove any duplicates of toys. So these two down here, we'd drop. Next up, we'd take a look at outdoors, and we'd remove any duplicates of it, and then industrial, and remove any duplicates of that as well. And so we end up with just the unique values, toys, outdoors, and industrial. These are the only values that we're going to have access to inside of this distinct or the select clause. So we cannot try to print out, say, the price for each of these. We're only going to see just these values by themselves. Let's take a look at a quick example of this. So back over here, we'll do a select distinct department from products and run that. So now in this list right here, we should only see unique values. We should not ever see a duplicate of, say, tools or toys or outdoors or so on. One very good use of this distinct keyword is to print out the number of unique values we have. To do so, we would wrap distinct department with a count aggregate function. We could then run that, and it will tell us the number of unique departments we have inside of our products table. So this is super useful anytime that you want to start to explore a data set and get an idea of how many, well, unique values you have. One thing you might notice right away is that distinct is kind of similar to group by, because they are both all about somehow taking a look at a column and removing duplicate records. In truth, you can use distinct or you can use group by in place of distinct, but you cannot use distinct in place of group by. Only group by can make use of aggregate functions to take a look at values inside of each of those different groups. So it's a lot more important for you to understand how group by works in general than it is for you to understand how distinct works. Now, if we ever want to find multiple different unique values, like let's say unique values across different columns, we could do a select distinct department and name. This will give us a list of all the unique combinations of these two columns. So it's going to find every unique combination of department and name put together. So if we run that, we're going to see way more records. So inside this list, we might see kids multiple times. There's a duplicate right there, but we will never see a row where we have the same department and the same name. Every single row, if we take the two values and join them together, will always be unique. Now, this is definitely useful, but there is a downside to it. If we do a distinct over two or more different columns, we can no longer do a count on it. So just a funny little restriction there. If we try to run this, we'll get an error like so. We can only do a count when we are finding distinct over one single column. But as soon as we add in that second column, or even another, nope, can't do a count anymore. All right, so that's distinct. Again, it's all about finding unique values inside of a column. It is functionally quite similar to group by, but group by is a little bit more powerful because it allows us to apply those aggregate functions to each interior group. That's pretty much it on distinct. Let's take a pause here and continue in just a moment.